Wonderful. She's such a blessing to all. Amen. And I thank God for reconnecting us back together again. I heard about all that she was doing. And you know, she's known in the streets of Jacksonville as Mama Audrey. Amen. Isn't that wonderful? Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. She didn't call herself that. People called her that because she was living that. Amen. Hallelujah. She was doing the work of God. Hallelujah. What God put in her heart. Amen. Hallelujah. So she is a member of Victory Tabernacle Church. Amen. And she also has a ministry, and they have a ministry called Outreach Hands. Amen. Outstretched Hands. I'm sorry. Amen. Hallelujah. They're stretching their hands out. Hallelujah. Blessing all the people. Amen. So many things that she's done. Amen. And I could go on and on, but I am going to just take this time. I want to present to some, introduce to some, none other, amen, than evangelist Audrey Turner. Let's thank God for her as she comes. Mama Audrey, God bless you, God bless you, God bless you. Oh, we thank God for you today. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I honor the Lord today. I praise him. I magnify him. I give him glory for just being here. Thank the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. For all that he's doing and all that he's going to do. I thank him. Praise God for the angels of this house. I thank the Lord for the bishop, for Pastor Pittman. Praise the Lord. I thank you, Jesus. I just magnify God. Praise God. I count it a privilege and an honor that they asked me to come at this time. And I am so grateful to God for what he's doing. Thank the Lord. Praise God. Hallelujah. Oh God, because I'm excited, you know, because God is doing great things.
Yes,
yeah. And I just want to be a part of the great things that he's doing. And she asked me about this mother thing, and I was like, oh my God, there's so many areas of being a mother. And I just, I'm not a person that write down a whole lot of stuff, so I just jot me a few little notes to keep up with where, if I get carried away, y'all just tell the Lord thank you. You know, I thought about the different aspects of mothers. You know, we got praying mothers, we got godly mothers, we got community mothers, we got mental mothers, we got family mothers, we got all kinds of mothers out there that, you know, standing in the gap and that doing so many great things. And first of all, I just want to take a little time right here and say, Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you for this chance, this opportunity. Oh God, give me something to say that it might touch somebody's heart today. Lord, we thank you for the word being rich and fruitful. And we thank you for doing it now in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. All right, now, I looked and I thought about all of these different mothers, and I thought about the different roles that each of us play as, for, you know, being a mother. And I said, first of all, we have to acknowledge God in order to be a good mother. And the one scripture that stood out in my mind as I was thinking about it was Proverbs, the 3rd chapter, verses 5 and 6. It said, trust in the Lord with all thine heart, and lean not into thine own understanding. In all thy ways acknowledge him, and he will direct thy path. I said, if we do that, we could be a good mother. You know, we could reach out, and we can touch, and we can do the work of the Lord. Okay? I thought about the godly mother. The mother that takes on the responsibility of standing in the gap for souls.
Yes. Yes.
One that cries out in the late, in the midnight hour.
Glory.
The one that walks the floor for not only her children, but other children.
Come on.
Not only for her daughters and her sons, but for other daughters and sons. And I was thinking about it. I said that, thank God for the godly mothers.
Yes.
And then I thought about the family mother. She's the one that nurtures the family and try to keep the family together. You know, she's the one that always you know, trying to tell the kids the right things to do and show them and live a life before them. And then you got the community mothers, and I consider myself one of them, who reaches out in every area. The community mother, she's on the streets. She's witnessing to the young men and women out there, you know, that has wandered away and gone astray. And she's out there just showing them that love to try to get them to know that there is somebody that cares for them. Yes. Not only the ones that out there, you have the ones that play in sports, you have ones that are in the entertainment field, you have ones that just need that mother figure, that someone that they could call in the time of need. Yes. And I thought about that, and I said that, you know, a lot of times we think of just mothering our children. But then I was sitting there just a few minutes ago, and the Lord said that sometimes people come through your life for a reason and for a season.
All right.
And it's up to you if you pour into them,
yes,
what they need,
yes,
for that reason and that season. And we have to pray and ask God, say, God, what do I need to do for this person at this time? Because people need, you know, when you being a mother, you that's a great responsibility.
Yes, it is.
You know, you just can't just say, okay, I'm just going to just do it like this or do it like that. But then you have to pray and consult God. And I thought about different mothers in the Bible, but the one that stood out in my mind was Moses' mother. Because Moses' mother had to make a decision.
Yes.
They was going to kill all the male children. You remember?
Yes.
The male boys. They would kill them all. And she decided, this boy is worth saving.
Yes.
And I thought about it. I said, some mother out there today is standing in the gap and praying for their son.
Yes.
Because
yes,
they are worth saving.
Come on.
They're praying for their daughters because they are worth saving.
Yes.
So what she did, she hid him until the time she put him in a safe place. And so I would say, you mother that praying for that son, that daughter, put him in a safe place. Put him in the hand of the Lord. That's the best place to put them. And you know what? He will take care of them. That's what he did for Moses. He took care of Moses.
Yes.
He put him in Pharaoh's house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's what God will do. He will take care of him. And then I thought about, I say a lot of times we tell our children and we try to lead them and guide them in the right way. And sometimes they listen and sometimes they don't. Sometimes they think that you're so hard on us. You know, and I could speak on that because I was a single mom raising six kids, and I tell you, four of them was boys, and that was hard. Very hard. Because, you know, boys, they tend to think ladies don't know nothing. You know. And they think mama's just mama. But then I had to tell them and I had to show them that, hey, life will deal you some stuff. And you got to know how to deal with it. So what I tried to do and to distill in them that, hey, whenever you are in situations, you will need God.
Yes.
So you need to pick up the word. So let's get the word. See what the word is about. So we had to have Bible study.
Yes.
We had to have study school in our house. We had to have prayer time and everything. Although they was involved in other things, you know, sports and stuff, we had to have our time to pray and consult God. Because I used to tell them all the time, I don't know how to do this by myself.
All right.
You know, I can't do this by myself. I need your help. Just, you know, I said, we need God's help and I need your help. So if you listen and I listen, we'll hear what God has to say. And in that, you know, things went smooth. And I would, you know, a lot of times we as mothers, we want to, you know, pamper them and whatever. I think my children tell you now, I was so hard on them. Because I told him, I said that life is going to come. The world ain't going to give you anything. You got to be strong. You got to work. You got to persevere. You got to pray. You got to fast. You got to want something out of life. I'm not saying all of them all good and all that. I have some that's, you know, kind of shaky. But guess what? I distilled that word in them. He said that if you put the word in them, they might go astray, but they'll come back. You know, all you got to do is do what you're supposed to do. And I remember when Paul was telling Timothy, when he was getting ready to give Timothy his traveling shoes to get into the ministry, he told him, he said that, remember what your mother and your grandmama put in you.
Yes.
Remember what they said to you. Remember how you saw them pray. Remember how you saw them walk. Remember the tears that they shed. Remember the things that they did. You know, when they saw somebody hungry, they fed them. When they saw somebody needed something, they saw about it. Remember the things that they did.
Amen.
See, I think that same stuff is in you. You know, and I can say, you know, that's what I try to distill in my children. The things that you see me do, you do it too. You know, but then a lot of times, you know, we don't do anything, so they don't see anything. But then God, He has entrusted so many things in our hand. And a mother have to be a person that has love. And love unconditionally. Not only do she have to have love, she has to be a person that can listen. Because sometimes you need to stop talking so much and listen to what they have to say. And I'm learning this day by day. Not only listen, but then you have to teach and you have to let your light shine. In the listening, as I walk the streets of Jacksonville, you know, trying to, you know, do what the Lord has assigned in my hand, sometimes I just have to listen to what somebody has to say. And a lot of times, what they have to say to me, you know, it just touches my heart, you know, to make me want to do more, you know, than I'm doing. Because a lot of times, folk need somebody just to listen to them. And then after listening, then sometimes you don't need to say anything. You just smile. And that brings joy to their heart. And sometimes you can give them a word that can encourage them to go a little further in life. You know, and I thought about being a mother is a great responsibility, and it's a ministry too. You know, and it's hard work. Because if you think about it, if you are raising children in this day, it's hard work. Because they have so much out there to offer them. And you know, when you are our age, they think us old, think that we're old-fashioned and old fogies. But then, when it comes down to it, they have to come back to you and say, Mama, it's so hard, I can't hardly make it. And you give them that same word you gave them before they got in the situation.
Amen.
You need God. You know, and then I look at it, I say, when we become mothers, our focuses change.
Amen.
It changed from ourselves to those who God has entrusted in our hands.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I know a lot of mothers right now, they are going through so much, and they are so depressed, and they are so down, but this morning I come to encourage them.
Yes.
Lift up your head, O ye gates.
Yes.
And be ye lifted up, you
yes.
everlasting doors.
Yes.
And let the King of glory come in.
Yes.
Who is this King of glory?
Yes.
The Lord God Almighty. He is the King of glory.
Yes.
And He will help you in every situation.
Yes.
He will be there for you.
Yes.
You might think things are hard. You might think you can't make it. But I'm here to tell you today, you can make it. Hallelujah. Just hang in there.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You know, a lot of times, praise God, hallelujah, Glory to God. We ought to be women of authority. You know, sometimes we have to take back. Mothers have to take back what the enemy has tried to take from us. Hallelujah. You have to get right in his face and say, you will not have my children. You will not have my seed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I take it back in the name of Jesus. I don't care if they're acting crazy right now. Hallelujah. But God, I take it back. I take them back. I take them back. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And a lot of times, praise God. Hallelujah. We forget what authority we have. Hallelujah. That authority to be tender and affectionate. Be caretakers and protectors. Hallelujah. And I'm finding out that I'm being mother to some women that are older than I am. Hallelujah. Sometimes they need some help. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Because I'll be telling them, I said that it is not the age now. It's the mindset. Yes. Hallelujah. Glory to God. But then if you get your mind stayed on the Lord, he'll keep you in perfect peace. Yes. Hallelujah. So I tell them all the time, I say, I don't mind. I don't mind mentoring whoever the Lord put in my hands. And I can relate to being a mother that mentors. Because I remember when the basketball girls I was a basketball mom, and the girls would always come to me, and you know, we would have prayer. You know, one thing I tell them, I said, you can't do nothing without God. You can be a champ if you got God. So let's pray. Hallelujah. And they got so funny, they would tell me, Mom, did you bring the oil with you?
Glory.
Put a little bit on my hand.
Come on, man.
You know, because, you know, we had one little girl who liked to do the three. Throw the three, the shot, you know, that three-pointer. She said all the time, I need that oil on my hand.
Come on.
And, you know, I'll be in the stand. When she hit it, she look over there and do give me the thumbs up. And I said, Lord, I just want to thank you. And when they went away to college, it was amazing how someone would call and just, you know, say thank you. You know, so that a lot of times we didn't have what we needed and you supplied the need for us. Thank you. A lot of times we didn't have nobody to talk to, but thank you. You know, yeah. And that's what we are here for. We are here for those kinds of things. You know, and a lot of times in the community, we are mothers. Because that young lady that don't know how the ends are going to meet, and you go in and you tell her, say, baby, if you put God first, he'll help you meet those ends. I said, everything will be all right. You know, but then I find out that I have fathers who raising children. Amen. And I have to tell them the same thing. Yep. I said, look here, young man. I said, if you're going to be the father that raising the children, you need God.
That's right.
Yeah. Hallelujah. You need him just like the lady needed.
That's right.
You know, that's why it's important that we as mothers train our sons to do things in the home, you know, because you don't ever know what's going to happen. You know, I used to tell my boys, I said, you got to learn how to wash. You got to learn how to cook. You got to learn how to keep the house. You got to learn all these things, how to dress the baby. You got to, come here, learn how to twist this hair up. Learn how to do some things. Because you know what? Life deals you all kinds of things. Hallelujah. Your wife might just lay down and die. And you love with those children. And please don't bring all to me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Everybody need to raise their own children. Hallelujah. And I try to tell them, I said, not only that, when your wife go to the hospital for whatever reason, you ought to be able to maintain your house. I shouldn't come over there and everything out of place. You know, just all messed up. Because I didn't raise you that way. And see, mothers, that's what they need to do now. Teach these children how to do things. You know, not only, you know, back in the old days, everybody said, well, I taught my daughters to do this. And my mama taught everybody, 13 children, everybody knew how to cook. Everybody knew how to wash dishes. Everybody knew how to go to work and provide for their families. Nobody stayed home. I could say some of them don't know how to do anything now. Because they're older. And know what they do? They're smart. They're so smart. They call the one that know how to do it. And they work together. But one thing about God, He is holding us responsible for meeting the needs of the people that He put in our pathway. Because He said in Psalms 103, ask God for guidance. Talk to God anytime, anywhere, and know that God listens. He listens to you. He will answer you. And sisters and brothers, I want to say to you today that find somebody that you can mother. Find somebody that you can help, because our world needs help today. Find somebody that you can just go to and say, baby, can I help you? Can I show you the way? Can I help you with your walk, your journey? You know? And it's something else to be a community mother. Because one thing I learned, in the community, everybody gives you respect. Everybody, when you live a life before them, they give you that respect.
Yeah.
You know, the children, they'll be going to take the bus on the corner, and I'll be in the yard, and somebody will say something, the other one will say, don't you see this? Aren't you standing out there? We don't talk like that.
Amen.
You know? Why? Because that motherly love, that community mother that's in the community that working with them, and see, when I see them and I have some goodies, I'll call them over. I say, come on over. I got something for you. And they remember that. You know? And then they'll go home and tell their moms, and their moms will come back, come around there, and say, thank you for being on that corner, because I can't be there all the time. A lot of folks don't know what their children are doing and saying, because they're not with them all the time. But if there's a community mom, if there's a mama, a mentor mom, they can be filling those spots for them. They can say to them, hey, you one of mine. You don't act like that. And when they get grown and go away, believe it or not, they'll call you and thank you. Say, thank you for chastising me. Thank you for keeping me straight. It has saved my life many times. And I thought about people that cross your path and you being a mother to them. I looked at Naomi and her daughter-in-law.
Yes.
I said that there was a time when if the son would pass away, the daughter-in-laws would go on and forget about the mother-in-law. But then Ruth, she said, I want to be the kind of woman that you are, Naomi. I want to be the kind of woman you are. I walk with you. I've been in the house with you. I know your prayer time. I know your fasting time. I know everything that's good about you, and I want to be like you. And I thought about it. I said, when we would go on trips for different events, when I was in the school system, and we went to conventions and stuff, and I would always get a roommate, and everybody would say, I don't want room with her, cause that sanctified lady, that Holy Ghost filled lady, she gonna preach all night and she gonna pray all night. I don't want a room with her. But then every time I would get a roommate, I didn't go crazy. At 5 o'clock in the morning, my prayer time, I would slip down on the side of the bed, and I wouldn't holler and scream and carry on. I would just say my little prayers, and I would get back in the bed, read my little scripture. I didn't know they was watching me, you know, people watching. And so one morning, this young lady got up at 5 o'clock. I was down praying. I heard her slip out the bed and get on her knees. And she said, oh God, I want some of that she got over there. I want to be able to pray like that. I want, you know, because she said she ain't making no noise. But then I know she's praying for me. the life that you live in front of them.
Yes.
The things that you do.
Yes.
You are making a difference in their lives.
Amen.
So now I would say to you mothers, mm-hmm. I would say to you, I thought about, there are mothers that has not, they didn't birth any children.
Amen.
You got some mothers out there that is just a mother.
Amen.
You know, they never birthed a child, but they got many children.
Yes.
Because they touched their lives. They said something to them. They loved on them. They made a difference by the walk that they walked and the talk that they talked. They didn't just say, just do what I'm doing. They lived that life in front of them. And guess what? They have children that they did not birth into this world. They call them mama.
Yes.
They call them mother at Mother's Day. They send them flowers. They call them on the phone because they made a difference in their lives. And I think about the Lord said, He'll go before us and He'll help us in the time of need. Whatever we need to be the best that we can be for Him, He will supply it. And today, I'm so excited because every time I think about it, every time I look around, like I tell everybody, I say, every time I look around, the Lord is just blessing. I said, somebody will come up and say, do you know I finally got myself together and I'm serving God now. You know, I always, I don't care where I go, but this young man, I was walking in this town, and there's a country town, and he was like, hey, Miss Archie. I said, what's that calling me? He said, I just want to let you know, I'm saved, I'm sanctified, and I'm preaching the gospel. I said, hallelujah. Glory to God. And then one of my best friends growing up, you know, she told me, she said that, I don't want none of that. You know, every time I would go home, I don't want none of that. And then I went home, and she told me, she said, girl, all that stuff that I didn't want, I got it. So that I'm preaching now, I'm serving God now, and that's the best life there is. She said that it's all because I saw what you all did. You know, how you all hung in there. You know, I know, she said, I know you was having hard times, because I gave you some hard times. But then prayer will change things and it will change people. And today, mothers, I know some of you are struggling. You're having a hard time. But put Jesus in there. Put him in the mix. Put him in there. Mix him up just like you would some bread or a cake or something. Put him in there. And guess what? He'll blend right on in. And he'll make things so much better for you. You'll say, oh my God, I didn't know it could get this good. And the children will get better. You'll say, oh my God, I didn't know they heard me when I said what I said. They'll call you up and say, mama, thank you.
Yes.
Well, I say, you might have been hard on me, but thank you. You know, I thank you for the chastisement. I thank you for the time. You know, sometimes I tell them, I say, I ain't bailing you out this time.
Right.
You gonna have to work on it yourself.
Right.
You gotta go to God for yourself. But mama, I just need you to pray. I ain't praying for you this time. It's your time to reach out to God for yourself.
Amen.
And one thing about a mama, that heart.
Yes.
You might say no, but that heart, it deep down inside, know what you're doing, you praying. Lord, pray about him. Lord, help him. Lord, change him. Lord, save him. But then when they walk in the room, you just man up. Like you ain't saying nothing. And then after a while, they said, mom, you was right. I had to call God for myself. I had to seek him out for myself.
Yes.
And said, you know what I've learned? He'll turn things around for you.
Yes.
I said, Lord, I thank you that I didn't. A lot of times, you don't tell God you don't step in there. Because sometimes we step in and we disable them. We mess up things. But now, today, I say to you, happy Mother's Day.
Yes.
And know this. That God is on your side.
Yes.
Whatever you're going through, He's gonna be in the through with you.
Yes.
So today I say to you, I thank God, I praise him, I glorify him, and I love what I do. I thank God for, you know, just keeping me, you know, strong, and I just love him.
Amen.
I praise him. I worship him.
Amen.
And I thank God for Voices of Joy giving me this opportunity. Yeah. And today I'm asking that you all pray for me. Of a mother. Hallelujah. That was an awesome word, Mama Audrey. Amen, evangelist. That was an awesome word. Amen. I know the people were blessed. Amen. I was just so blessed. I was standing over there cheering. Amen. So many wonderful nuggets and things that we can hold on to. Amen. Hallelujah. I love the part where she said that she would talk to that young man that's trying to raise those children or that young woman and say, you got to get God. You've got to have God in your life. You can't do this by yourself. Hallelujah. Glory to God. My God. And I know that's the heart, hallelujah, of mothers. Amen. That their children, oh, would just be in the things of God, that they would come to the Lord, that they would surrender their life to the Lord, amen, so that they can be blessed and so that their children can be blessed as well. Hallelujah. So, Father, we just thank you. We thank you for this word today, God. What an awesome word. Hallelujah. We bless you, Father God, and we receive that word. Oh, Father God, we take it in, Lord God. Hallelujah. To continue on, Father God, even if we haven't born any children, physically or biologically, so many children, so many people need a mother. My God, just say, Lord, let me be that mother. Let me send me somebody. Let me go out there and find somebody. Just leave me, Father, because there's so much need for a godly mother. Amen. And so we just thank you, Father. Lord, we give you the glory. We bless you for Mama Audrey. Thank you, Lord, for giving her the strength, God, to just continue on and to do your work, Father God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, we thank you right now. Hallelujah. And if there's anyone today that's watching this time, amen, and you don't know the Lord as your Savior, this is the right time. Amen. My God, this is the right time. I tell you, the presence of God is here. Hallelujah, to save your life. Amen. Hallelujah. You don't have to keep going in the wrong direction. It's time to go in the right direction, because you've got to not only be a blessing for yourself, but you got to be a blessing for your seed. Amen. And for those, amen, that will be your seed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. So we just want to say, come on the Lord's side, amen, just as you are right now. Oh, hallelujah, it's not hard. Just make that decision today. I want to say, choose Jesus. He is the only way. He's the truth and he's the life. Hallelujah, glory to God. You will be blessed on the side, hallelujah, on the side of Jesus, on the team of Jesus. Amen, hallelujah, glory to God. So bow your head with me and pray this prayer with me, hallelujah. Lord Jesus, come into my life, Lord God. Oh, Father God, you know how I've lived, Father. Lord, I ask you to forgive me, Father. Oh, I repent of my sins. I believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He died for me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And God, you raised him from the dead. And I ask you to come into my life. I just give my life over to you. From this day forward, Lord God, I say, live in my life. Live big in me. Live bold in me. I need you, Lord God. Oh, thank you, Father, for saving my soul and making me whole. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. If you prayed that prayer with me in sincerity today, hallelujah, you are a child of God. Tell somebody, call your mother, or call your auntie, call somebody, amen, your sister, call your brother, and let them know that I've accepted Jesus, I gave my life to Jesus, I repented of my sins, hallelujah, glory to God. God is good, and he's faithful, amen, thank you, Lord, hallelujah.